few loves Polly quite like Sam, and few know Polly's place quite like Mike. So we're indebted that they would join us. Mike Sheehan, welcome.
Hi, Jared.
Hello, Robbo.
Hello, Mick.
Sam Newman, welcome to AFL 360.
Thank you.
How close was your bond to Polly, Sam?
Well, look, I don't want to overestimate that aspect of my relationship with Polly Farmer. He had plenty of friends at Geelong. Well, he had a select few friends at Geelong. He wasn't an ebullient man. He was a insular man, private, humble, shy, reserved. I had great affection for him. I revered him. I know this sounds a bit hokey, but he was my great inspiration in my football life. And almost my life, if you look back at where he came from, what he achieved, how he achieved it, and why he is, or why he was, what the person he was.
You admired him unconditionally, didn't you?
Unconditionally.
And I know you well, and there are very few people that could say that.
I did. I admired him for his physical prowess on the football field, but he was a much more complex person than that. He had tremendous mental capacity. He could work out the aspect of a game almost in a nanosecond. He never wasted any energy doing things he wasn't capable of doing. He was measured. He was composed. He was cool inside and very hot outside. Very hot outside. Never, always gave receipts. Was never compromised. And
just gave receipts, mate.
Well, if you belted him, he would belt you back, but you'd never know where it came from. I watched this at first hand. This is the legacy, if you like, of playing 4 years with a man, almost playing 100 games alongside him, and just watching him, how he went about his craft. And besides the mental and physical aspect of him, his spirituality, you might think that unusual to say that, but his great love of the game and what he brought to it from his Indigenous background was absolutely amazing.
Can I keep going here? Sorry, Robert.
No, I'm listening.
The thing, my memory is that I never knew him to be a target of any racial abuse in a time when anyone else black was often belittled from over the fence. Is that true? Was he abused racially?
I've been asked this several times today for probably obvious reasons. And I've reflected on it, and since I'm here now, unless I have absolute selective memory and I'm just not wishing that to be the case, I don't remember one instance when anyone he played against or anyone in the crowd ever traduced him or maligned him for what he was, not for who he is.
It's interesting you say that, because I watched a video today and he was interviewed about this. And he said that he was racially abused a lot, and he said it wasn't my problem, it was the person's problem. Mm. And all I did is I never spoke back to him. All I tried to do was beat him as a footballer.
By his opponents, he's
saying. That's what he said in this video today.
Was that in Victoria?
No, it's a good point. He played, 200-and-so goals games for over in Perth. It may have been in Perth.
Because I played for 4 years with him, and I think he played 101 games for Geelong. I must have played about 80 with him. I think he played in 63, of course, he did. So he would have played 20 games. So I honestly never heard anyone I played with or against say anything about his heritage.
He's one of the rare figures who changed the game through his craft. How did you observe that?
That is a very good point. He is the only person that's changed the way the game has played. That's his great legacy. People might say it's gone to an extreme, but besides a couple of rule changes for people bouncing the ball and pretending they were held when they threw the ball out in front of them and all.
Hello, Kevin.
Kevin, that's right. Good luck to Kevin. He got away with that until they changed the rule for him, a bit like Walter Lindrum. But Polly was the first, and absolutely the first, in 1962 to use handball as an offensive weapon. He would do it for two reasons. He thought it was far quicker to get the ball out quickly with a hand pass rather than try and kick it. And he absolutely deliberately tried to bring younger players, more inexperienced players, into the game in the opening 10 seconds or 20 seconds of it by giving him a kick. Mm. And he's legendary for that. And he was the commensurate. Mm. He was the commensurate team player. Is that the word, Nick? The ultimate team player. Not that he went out of his way to let anyone else mark the ball when he thought he could mark it, but he brought everyone into the game, and he was just a supreme player.